This example shows how the Bernoulli equation is applied in a Pitot tube, which is being used to measure the velocity of a boat. Can also be used to measure the velocity of a plane, but in this example it's for a boat as it's moving through water. Picture this tube here. It's kind of like a manometer tube in a way, and it's attached to a boat, and the boat is moving at a velocity of u through the water. So if we consider the captain of the boat's perspective, then the tube is actually stationary and the water is moving at a velocity of u. So the water is all moving at a velocity of u right here. Now what happens is that first moves at a velocity of u through this tube until it gets sort of stuck at this point and it turns up, and then it's pushing a column of water up into this tube, which at a certain point, the pressure head, due to this additional height above the ambient pressure, so this height is a height of h, and this point right here we're going to call point 2, and this is point 1. The pressure at point 2 is ambient, as is the pressure right above the surface of the water, but this pressure head right here of rho gh is counterbalancing the speed of the boat. The faster it moves, the higher this moves up here, and so this point right here is called a stagnation point, because obviously for the fluid inside this tube to not be moving, the velocity really must be zero right there. But right on the other side of it, the velocity is u, because that's how fast the water is hitting this now stationary column of water. This tube is at a depth of d below the surface, and so the pressure here at point 1 is equal to p ambient plus rho g d, and the pressure here at point 2 is p ambient, because both point 2 and the surface of the water are exposed to the ambient air. So if we apply the Bernoulli equation to this fluid, then u1 squared over 2 plus p1 over rho plus gz1 is equal to u2 squared over 2 plus p2 over rho plus gz2. So we'll call point 1 at a height of 0, which makes point 2 at a height of d plus h. p1 is equal to p2 plus rho gd. Because of what we said earlier, p2 is ambient and p1 is ambient plus rho gd. u2 is 0 because it's not moving at this point, and while it's not moving just to the right of point 1, the fluid is trying to move at a velocity of u just to the left of point 1. And so u1 is really the velocity of the boat, and so that's u. We can simplify this equation a little bit by saying u1 squared over 2 plus p1 over rho is equal to g times d plus h, plugging in for z2, plus p2 over rho. And because of the fact that we explained above that p1 is equal to p2 plus rho gd, we can plug in right here for p1 and rewrite this equation on the left-hand side as u1 squared over 2 plus, I'm plugging in for p1 right here, p2 over rho plus gd. Now, taking this side of the equation and setting it equal to this side of the equation, I see that I get a gd on each side, u1 squared over 2 plus gd. I have a p2 over rho on each side. Those cancel out, as do the gds. I can solve for u1 as u1. I'm going to take the square root of both sides. u1 is equal to the square root of 2gh. The column of fluid in the pitot tube above the surface of the water translates to the velocity of the boat. The kinetic energy of the water right before it enters the pitot tube is converting to pressure energy at the top surface of the fluid in the pitot tube. So we can measure a height, or obviously that wouldn't work very well for air on an airplane. You could use a pressure transducer to measure the pressure that is required to counteract the velocity at which the pitot tube is moving through the fluid, or vice versa. The fluid is moving over the pitot tube.